So this design problem, more or less the one of the simple possible problems I had given to you. There are choices with respect to percentage excess and percentage conversion, and the reaction could fall in regime 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. So how to take decision? So some of you have done wonderful job. I'll make that presentation and then how to take a decision that I will detail. Okay. Are you able to read?
Yes.
Yeah. So how to calculate volume is known to us. We know how much production we want. That indeed tells us how many kilomoles per second should get reacted. That we know. And after confirming the conditions for regime 1, 2, 3 or 4, we use appropriate rate of reaction, overall rate of reaction. By regime 1, 2, 3 or 4, what we mean is, by now we know what is the rate controlling step and we are capable of finding the overall rate of reaction. So rate of production in kilomole per second divided by overall rate of reaction gives the volume, right? What is not known to us at the beginning is what should be the percentage excess and what should be the conversion, right? So have you solved? Because two answers have come to me. And the problem has been addressed very nicely. All of you, have you done it? Have you submitted that to your CRs, respective CRs? You submit it. Otherwise, let me give you one more option. The some answers which have been obtained by your classmates, I am exhibiting them here, and they need to be taken further for completing the exercise, and you submit it next time. Okay. This particular part will be emailed to you, whatever answers are there. Use these answers for further casting. Right. If I remember, for one particular case we had estimated volumes in the class, that is 1% excess individually. Now I remember there were four rows, and each row was estimating volume for each regime. Just see, first column is what? Just serial number. These are various possibilities. Percentage excess, I think there will be a case of 1%. So. Or it starts from 5%. Right. So 1%, 5%, 10%, and this entire sheet is for regime 1? Right. Then conversion is assumed to be 80% till 100% excess. Then conversion is 85%, and excess is again from 1% to 100%. Conversion is 90%, 95%. And is there a case of 99%? Yeah. Okay. So that gives the percentage excess will give the partial pressure, and partial pressure multiplied by Henry's coefficient will give a star values. Concentration of toluene is dependent upon excess of toluene at the conversion. 80% conversion means 20% remains. So this is B naught, and as the conversion increases, obviously the B naught decreases. Overall volumetric rate of reaction and therefore volume and 2.5 kW meter cube multiplied by 10 rupees is what is overall. Have you understood the overall the method? Yes or no? Yes?
Yes,
sir. So this is taken further. Here if you see, the conversion is 95%. That is conversion, B naught will be close to zero, and S star of course, whatever is the value, depending upon percentage excess, accordingly volumes are there. So if you go on the other side, the volume has been plotted versus percentage excess. And most probably colors will be extent of conversion. Yeah. So we should go on that side. Okay. Two thumbs. So you can see about 2,000-3,000 meter cube volume is required for 99% conversion and 1% excess. That is the, is that green line topmost or yellow? Green. So when you go to higher and higher conversion, then you definitely go to green line. But when conversion is 80%, B naught is high, and with high B naught, as percentage excess increases, so for 80% conversion, 20% remaining, the volume is changing from about 15 meter cube to most probably, if I'm correct, it is 2 meter cube or 2.5 meter cube. So on the plot itself, you can see that the volumes are right from 2000 meter cube to 2 meter cube. Okay. Up to this, you have understood, I'm sure. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So I think we should have now further columns. That is, what is the capital cost? That is one. The next is, if chlorine is excess, then how much NaOH? And I found that it is 42 rupees per kg. So as the volume goes down, mainly because of percentage chlorine, suppose it is 60% excess. Molecular weight of chlorine is how much? 71. Molecular weight of toluene is 92. So we know kilomoles per second reacting. Accordingly, we know kilomoles per second of chlorine reacting. And depending upon percentage excess, we know how much is chlorine unreacted. And 1 mole of chlorine will generate 1 mole of HCl and will need 1 mole of NaOH. So we can have another column, that caustic multiplied by 42 rupees, how much is the money required for that? And then for percentage excess, we need to have distillation column. Very good part is, once the system is defined, that it is toluene and benzyl chloride, the number of theoretical stages don't change. Depending upon the relative proportion of toluene and benzyl chloride, only the feed plate will change. We can get, this is very interesting, very interesting. Now the column diameter will be, against, if the number of theoretical stages is constant, once we know the system, we know purity at the top, we know purity at the bottom, the number of stages are independent of what is the feed flow rate. And the diameter depends upon you are in the third year, final year in Cambridge. If you are in third year, distillation is not taught, I think. Distillation is yet to be covered. Mecathyl diagram, etc. Sounds familiar?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you drawn that diagram yourself?
Yes.
How to draw equilibrium line? How to locate the product concentration point? From that, how to draw operating line? What is the slope of that line? R upon R plus 1. And after drawing that line, then we need to draw stripping section. Yeah, that is right. But anyway, that is familiar to you, and you find the theoretical stages. I'm repeating same thing and making the same statement, that diameter depends on. So that answer I'm not getting. Yeah. Very good, very good. So this also, have you, that is chemical engineering economics is a subject. When it is, it's final year. And there are some students here who are final year students, correct, no? So you can find the cost, but what we will do now, just now, means as far as your requirement is concerned, let us find out how much caustic is required and what is the... So one operating cost is in terms of energy, another operating cost is in terms of caustic soda. Whenever percentage excess is there, the volume goes down by 1,000 from 2,000 anyway. Those starting assumptions were so extreme that it gave the... But for you people, there is nothing extreme. It gave some answers, so that's okay. So it gave 2,000, it gave 2 meter cube. But for 2 meter cube, it is 100% excess. So for 50 tons per day, I don't know, maybe 20 tons per day is caustic required for that purpose. Actually, in an operating plant, the serious problem is something else. 100% excess, only 2 meter cube volume. The kilowatt required is 2.5 times 5 kilowatt, and it is very miniaturized design. For 50 tons per day, you are needing such a small volume, 2 meter cube, and motor of also 5 kilowatt. There cannot be simpler than that. And we accept such a simple answer, and chlorine is 100% excess. The value is okay. Definitely, we should take decision. But these NaCl which is formed in our plant, what is to be done with that is a bigger problem rather than spending money. You will not realize now when you go to operating plant, then this problem. What is the seriousness of the problem? That is, from your plant, you are permitted to release waste stream so that COD is less than 200. Are you aware what is the meaning of COD? Chemical oxygen demand? Right. And total dissolved solids, which is termed as TDS, that limit is also there, say 500. And if you are making, if caustic required having molecular weight 40, and NaCl is how much? How much is 58.5. So approximately 50% more, you will get sodium chloride. So 20, 30 tons per day sodium chloride. So obviously, it cannot be in the waste stream. And then NaCl, we need to have different ways, and that is difficult. That is very difficult. Anyway, for us, let us find the costs. So I'm sure now you have understood up to this point percentage excess and working volume. So what I'm telling one who has solved and presented in this form, you find the need of caustic. You do it just now. And convert it into kg per second. You are taking 1 year as basis, no? The kilowatts required multiplied by 10 rupees, have you done it per day or per? Then take one per day, that is okay. So day you will know how much NaOH required. Now in terms of distillation, again number of theoretical stages, they definitely depend upon what is purity required. So definitely we want good purity as far as benzyl chloride, the product, is concerned. But the top product, toluene, if you want 99.9%, then number of theoretical stages are high. But anyway, unreacted toluene is to be recycled. So if there is some quantity of benzyl chloride, which is a product, then we should find out whether 99% is a good idea, 95% is a good idea, or 90% is a good idea, by which number of theoretical stages will go down on one side. But the load on the reactor, the unreacted toluene will come back to the reactor. Load on the reactor increases, the volume of the reactor increases, and again you need to calculate the reactor volume. Have you understood overall exercise? Let me explain it to you. understood overall flow sheet. So the raw materials are toluene and chlorine, what is entering the process, and if you put a big line chlorine, toluene, that is input. What is that we have formed? This aqueous HCl is also one of the product. So if you are able to sell aqueous HCl, then that is a good idea. But at present, the present situation, the chemical industry is in such a way that we need to pay somebody for taking away HCl from our plant. All right. So that is a problem. If you want to kill it with NaOH, additional caustic will be required and additional problems of NaCl. Similar, there was yesterday only the same problem, but product was different. The molecule may be having molecular weight of 500, but for we chemical engineers, whatever is the production divided by molecular weight is kilomoles per second to be formed. In our case, it is 92, yesterday it was 500. So it is not important. That is not important. Whether it is in regime 1, 2, 3, 4, or in between 1, 2, or in between 1, 2, 3, just find out and find the volume. The real problem was what is to be done with HCl. And because of my background, I knew that our country needs ethyl chloride. C2H5Cl, and the reaction between ethanol, C2H5OH, and HCl, the only need is HCl should not have any water. So the HCl, a molecular weight of ethanol? 46. And ethyl chloride? 64.5. This benzyl chloride is out. 64.5 and 46. These are the respective molecular weights. So then another system of HCl, which is not absorbed with, so this equipment is not there. Then this equipment is, you put now ethyl alcohol from the top and take ethyl chloride as a product. And again, it is a multiphase reaction. The point is, the molecular weight is 46 ethanol and cost is 40 rupees. Ethyl chloride having molecular weight which is at least 40% more, that is kg is 75 rupees. Are you understanding? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Right. So what has happened is the product is made by only one company of that 500 molecular weight. I'm not telling you the product as well as company. The international price is $3 and the cost of production without introducing this idea was $2.2 and the profit of $0.8 was not very interesting. Therefore, I suggested this possibility and $2.2 came down to $1.1 because so $1.1 and $3 that was very profitable and the decision yesterday has been to make 5,000 tons per year to begin with and then later on to be expanded to 10,000 tons per. I can definitely take you to how much property can be prepared by approaching. Now, HCl, the amount is known, this ethyl chloride can be. But if you go back to the original problem, we can calculate the volume. Benzyl chloride is a product, aqueous HCl is product. Right now it doesn't have a value, it has a negative value. NaCl also has a negative value and NaOH is input. So whatever is this decision, for which we can find the volume. For the volume, we can find the volume of the equipment and I have already told you and which you will learn next year in chemical engineering economics, yearly cost is approximately 20%. It entirely depends upon what is the rate of interest, 12%, 13%, and the rate of depreciation. And if the life of the equipment is assumed to be 10, then linear depreciation is 10% per year. So 12% of interest and 10% of depreciation, the total annualized cost of the equipment becomes 22% of the. There are various ways of depreciation which you will learn next year. But there is a depreciation of equipment. Life is, it has equipment has a life. So it has a cost. So that we include and now what is the third is electric whatever is 10 rupees for one unit, that amount has been written. Have you already calculated the next one, the caustic required? For one of those options.
So the basis is 50 tons per day of product.
Uh-huh.
So depending on that, the volume will change, but the NaOH required would be the same. The production is 50 tons per day.
Very good. But what happens is, suppose you are providing excess, that chlorine is unreacted. And that excess chlorine, therefore, if you see the flow sheet, HCl is absorbed in water, chlorine relative has less solubility and that goes to caustic and NaOH, twice NaOH plus chlorine gives NaCl plus NaOCl. So you need for all percentage excesses the NaOH required. And for 100% excess, you can imagine how much caustic is required and calculate that. So after, I think, that is, if there is a volume of stirred reactor, how to get the cost, I think I covered one of those classes. Yeah, but third year students told me that it was not their class, it was BKMing class. BKMing, did we calculate from volume the thickness, the weight and multiplied by stainless steel cost and nothing like that? It doesn't matter, it is either covered or not covered and even if it is covered, taught again, it doesn't matter, it's useful, always useful. So what is that we have done is, this is 50, then we know toluene and chlorine. So chlorine and toluene is input to the plant, whereas output is benzyl chloride, aqueous HCl and sodium chloride. Of course, one more input is NaOH for killing the killing HCl as well as chlorine. So the cost in terms of raw materials, we have been able to find. Cost in terms of energy, we have been able to find. Now we need to find what is the capital cost associated with the reactor, associated with distillation column, associated with absorber of water first, followed by NaOH. So all these equipment, after design, suppose there is a pack column and which is a classical pack column for absorption, then we again find the number of theoretical stages, or that particular part I will cover, that is, if gas liquid reaction is in plug flow manner, particularly in the pack column, how to handle it, so that how to design that column. But more or less procedure remains the same. I will cover maybe for 4 or 5 types of reactions. Now here the gas phase is backmixed and liquid phase is also backmixed. Soon I am going to cover liquid is backmixed but gas is plug flow, and pack column is in such a way that liquid is plug flow and gas is plug flow. Solve problems under each category. But ideal plug flow is not there in any equipment, and ideal backmixed is also not there in any equipment. Then gas phase in between plug flow and backmixed, liquid phase in between plug flow and backmixed, how to approach the problem, all right? That those problems we will formulate, and like in this case, the way in which we found the volume was the rate of production divided by rate of reaction. There we need to solve differential equations so that toluene at the top has certain kilomole per meter cube, and with 99% we can serve the education, yeah, equations. How to handle this? NaOH we can find out very easy, that is simple. How to calculate the capital cost? I'm told by Dr. Rathod that he is solving one problem. Some homogeneous reaction and backmix reactor volume has been found. The plug flow reactor volume has been found, and plug flow volume is much smaller than the, and that plug flow reactor is being considered in the form of pipeline, and in order to confirm that it is plug flow, we need Pecklin number greater than 10, and therefore various length to diameter ratios are being considered, and for which Pecklin number has been calculated. And today only you have come up to this point, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Have you calculated the Pecklin numbers? Did you have any case where Pecklin number was greater than 10?
Yes.
So that was indeed plug flow. What is remaining is, we can do it in the pipeline, but soon you will learn that the pipe length can be, it is likely that the pipe length is 500 meters and it can go out of the plant, our plant, that much length. So that is converted into coil. Right. So coil can accommodate any length. After coil, then it has been, the case considered is heat exchanger. So reaction happens on the tube side, or reaction happens on the shell side. The major problem is, on one side, the volume of the reactor flow should happen, the cost of the reactor, the delta P multiplied by Q is electric requirement, right? And there is a heat of reaction, and we need to take care of heat of reaction. And area required, did you calculate area required for today? Now you will complete this exercise, you will complete this exercise. And for that case, I think for the pipeline, the cost was calculated or will be calculated. So what do we do? Suppose one of the answers is 100 meter cube. You know diameter, you know the height, and the thickness is pressure, operating pressure multiplied by 1.4, because we should operate at a pressure which is less than design pressure. So multiplied by 1.5 multiplied by diameter upon permissible stress into welding efficiency multiplied by 2, that gives the thickness. We provide approximately 3 millimeters for corrosion, and that gives the thickness. There are ways to calculate the thickness of dished end, and we get the cost of the reactor. And then there are ways to calculate the cost of shaft and cost of impellers, but entirely on the basis of weight. All right. So 10 meter cube, it can be 80 lakhs, and 2000 can be something, but 2000 is not very high. Now the next example I am solving, real example, if you come to my house, the solution is being attempted, and I have a blackboard at home. On the board, 10,000 meter cube is the stirred vessel having multiple stirrers inside and being solved for converting cashew nut apples into CNG. Have you seen cashew nut apples? One who has not seen, raise your hands. Those who don't know cashew nuts, raise your hand. Cashew nuts, there is one. All of you, are you having smartphones? Everybody? So you type cashew nut apple. Everybody, don't copy somebody. But on internet, everybody will see the same picture, so there is no copy. I see some inactive eyes. Plenty inactive eyes. I will take a round. I'll take a round now. Everybody become active. Anybody found? It looks very nice. Are you can find on this now? That is simple. Yeah. I forgot. Let me see who is lazy. Everybody should have cashew nut apple. You have it? Does it look nice?
Yes.
You are cashew nut apple?
I have a tree at home.
So nice. So you are in Kokan area?
No. It's a, like for ornamental purpose, not like a plantation.
Very good, very good. See his one. Get his same thing. But that is also cashew nut. So cashew nut apple, whatever is the molecular weight, the fermentation reactor, if you see any petrol pump or CNG pump, typically 5 tons per day are sold. Can any petrol pump come in front of your eyes? Very well. And CNG pump also? It is there. So per day consumption is typically 5 tons per day. And material balance says that for 5 tons per day, 200 tons per day of cashew nut apples are required. 200 tons per day. This is mainly because cashew nut apples contain 80% water and 20%. So there is a reaction for which 10,000 meter cube is the reactor. I'm telling you the process of designer. Alcohol is formed. Methane is formed, but together with methane, carbon dioxide is also formed. And carbon dioxide is not acceptable as far as vehicle application is concerned, and we need to purify. So absorber. So first multiphase reactor is cashew nut apple to methane. So methane is a gas, your product is gas, and cashew nut apple is a raw material. Then that is taken, first of all, in all such biological reactions, H2S and mercaptans are formed. And the smell is not very good. So we need to remove, and anyway, mercaptans and H2S, these are very corrosive. So they are not permitted in internal combustion engine. So that is to be scrubbed with caustic. Quantity is not high, but sufficient for corrosion. That is to be scrubbed. So now the entire methane plus CO2 quantity plus H2S is to be absorption, which is NaOH. Now what we need to keep is only H2S is absorbed and not CO2. You have done experiment in the laboratory, lean CO2 plus NaOH giving sodium carbonate. And what is the regime of operation? Third, and you found the interfacial area. Has this experiment been done in the laboratory? Right. So can you think of this? I'll give a price of 1,000 rupees. H2S is acidic gas, CO2 is acidic gas, and we should arrange the conditions in such a way that H2S is absorbed and not CO2. What can be done? Whatever theory we have studied up till now, I have taught you just now, last whatever 10 hours, 20 hours, is more than sufficient to give this answer. 1,000 rupees price today. The highest price I have kept up till now is one who solves those 44 problems, that is the highest price. I'll recommend you, and I will use all my contacts to get you whatever you wish to have. No, you final year people, you don't know this, but it is, you can also do that. You can also. But you are not familiar with those 44 problems. You don't know. Send? Check your mail, check your mail. 44 problems I've been told to you also. Okay, only 1,000 rupees for this. H2S is more acidic than CO2. Can you feel this? Can you appreciate this? H2S is. So the reaction between H2S and NOH is faster for H2S than CO2. All right. So we can select an equipment with appropriate value of KL. KL for packed column is in the range of 3 into 20 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter per second, whereas bubble columns are 20 into 70 into 10 raised to. The exercise which I completed for one company in United States, they wanted KL 10 times this, then how to innovate totally new equipment, that story also I'll tell you later on. But right now let us solve CNG problem. So get KL, arrange B0 and rate of reaction in such a way that CO2 NOH remains in third regime and H2S is in fourth regime. You know that in the fourth regime, it is mass transfer coefficient multiplied by A star. That is the only, I'm sorry, only B naught, correct? So by organizing this, you provide only that much height in the column where fourth regime and H2S gets absorbed and whatever remains, you don't bring in contact with NOH. So the rates of absorption, we arrange KL and B0 in such a way that rate of absorption of H2S is 100 times more than the absorption of CO2. So entirely H2S gets absorbed and maybe 1% of CO2, that is the solution, followed by there is a mixture of now CO2 and methane, CH4. So the one equipment I explained to you is rotating disc contactor. Do you remember? So another multiphase reactor. The first one is a fermenter gas liquid reactor, 10,000 meter cube volume. The input is 200 tons per day of cashew nut apples. The output on the other side is a mixture of CO2 plus methane plus H2S. So H2S absorption is another multiphase equipment. Then CO2 to be removed with water, CO2 has solubility and that equipment can be designed. It can be again rotating disk contactor or a pack column. Rotating disk contactor has negligible pressure drop, even less than pack column. Having designed that equipment, then what is to be done with water which has a lot of CO2? Right. So, an equipment for desorption, that is another multiphase equipment. So, at the top of a pack column, you add this CO2 and water. The CO2 that is formed in the reaction and now separated. Now you learn what is innovation. This now CO2 will go to greenhouse, and the productivity in the greenhouse, you know, photosynthesis reaction, and if you increase the concentration of CO2 up to certain level, you can increase the productivity, perhaps again cashew nut apples, by a factor of 2 or 3 or 4 depending upon CO2 that you pass. Right? Understood? So, that is another multiphase reaction, followed by then now we have methane, and then methane goes to the, of course, it has to be compressed before it can go to vending machine. So, all these calculations you will see in the blackboard which is there. Right, today we, it is sun energy. So, we removed all that. We removed all that, yeah, okay. But somebody, students are very, you students are very intelligent. Somebody took a photograph of whatever was written. The point is, when we try to solve any example, we need to make it economical. And there is no example in this world which cannot be solved. Have you understood this statement? We need to be innovative. However, no problem is simple problem. Okay? We need to respect every problem, but ultimately we get solution for every problem. That kind of confidence you should keep in your mind. And that happens only when you design multiphase reactors up to the end. Do it up to end. You will face some difficulties. As a new engineer, you can ask in terms of any reaction that you should be now, you now know about how many reactors? Plenty. And even plenty like stir cell and laminar jet apparatus, all kinds of reactors you know. So, coming back, hey, very nice. I did not see this. I wanted apple, but I got cashew nuts also on top of that. Good. So, this 200 tons per day, all is not reacted. 50% is conversion, only 50% gets converted into methane. And whatever is not converted, 50%, can be made amenable for fermentation. That is yet another innovation. You must have seen or not seen, go to Pandit Sir's laboratory, and there is a huge amount of research ongoing on cavitation. And very recently, our institute received an innovation award using hand pumps purify water, the principle of cavitation. So, for 50% unconverted, use cavitation, make it amenable for making another quantity that will be another multiphase reactors, another H2S another CO2. And but whatever is not converted has a excellent fertilizer property. These apples are available in 2 rupees a kilogram. Fertilizer can be sold 3 rupees a kilogram. Why I'm telling you these stories? First of all, these are interesting. Is it not?
Yes.
Yeah, these are interesting. You should get yourself exposed. There is everything has price. Thing has price. There is nothing that 2 rupees a kilogram is a. We feel that it is a very low price, but we are buying 200 tons per day. So I was imagining yesterday evening how many cashew nut apples are produced and how many plants I should install. So in the districts of Ratnagiri and Sindhudurg, are you getting order of magnitude, Ratnagiri and Sindhudurg? Where are they located? Are they in Uttar Pradesh? Just north of Goa. 100 plants can be installed. 100 plants. Each one is 200 tons multiplied in 100 requests. Right now, the use of is 0%. I'm repeating, cashew nut apple has a life of 2 hours. These are grown only in 2 months, and right now percentage use is zero. CH4 price is 46 rupees, fixed by central government. 100 plants, 5 tons per day, multiplied by year, multiplied by 46 rupees, how much wealth can be generated? Correct? So develop expertise in multiphase reactor design, and there I can keep on and on and on, and only conclusion is there are practically infinite number of opportunities which are not yet tapped in our country, and the actual solution to the problem of engineers having not job. All right. I have calculated that in this manner 3 crore engineers can be employed. So think big, but think real. Think big, but think real. So I got drifted a little bit, but having a requirement of caustic, now you calculate the cost of the reactor, cost of the distillation column, and then for distillation, again, steam is required. So that is also operating system. When all of them will tell us that that is whatever is conversion and the chlorine which is introduced in percent excess. Can I stop here? Will you be able to calculate the remaining? What I will do, let me tell these final year students to complete it. So next column is caustic requirement, taking care of chlorine. All right. Then later on, you design toluene benzyl chloride distillation column. Find the number of theoretical stages. But that exercise will go on and on. If you take anyway benzyl chloride and toluene is to be recycled, why we should have 99% excess? If the distillation column is small with 95%, 90%. So what is required? Whenever the distillation is incomplete, the same toluene will come back for the distillation column again and again, and then the distillation column size will be bigger. As against, the height will be different. All right? So if you can go up to that, that is great. But even if you stop up to the volume of the reactor, now you people have completed chemical engineering economics. You now know how to calculate thicknesses, you know how to calculate the cost. Imagine 10% interest, 10% of depreciation, find annualized cost and the cost of the reactor completely. All right? To which, if possible, add the cost of distillation column, its steam requirement, and do that completely. Okay. I am going to solve one more problem. No, I am going to solve many more problems. Many more. The next one is, which is I think circulated to you, which I wrote in Handbook of Chemical Engineering, and that is available with you. Correct?